Boom, boom. Boom, boom. And on that note, it's back to the Bahamas and some sharks.
I was on an adventure in the Bahamas to meet these beauties, Caribbean reef sharks. But would I be able to prove they're not as scary as they look and also be able to feed them by hand? Believe it or not, a shark's worst enemy is man. And get this, you're more likely to be killed by a coconut falling on your head than you are by a shark. I also had a little surprise. Zoe had turned up to give me some moral support.
Honey, I've arrived!
Hey, Zoe!
Oh, hiya!
Oh, I heard yesterday went really well.
Hey!
This is Stuart.
Nice to meet you.
Good to see you.
So
yeah,
what?
It was fun. It was really good.
And what about today?
Very well.
Oh, great.
Hopefully I'll be all right. I'm actually going to be feeding them today, so I'm a bit nervous, but it will be good.
Sharks are highly evolved animals with a really good sense of smell. They can even detect a drop of blood in an Olympic-sized swimming pool.
There's a lot of sharks right now. So it's going to be a lot of action. They're going to be banging into you. It's going to be a bit intimidating, so just be calm. And if you don't like it, we'll stop feeding. To feed the sharks, we have to use the spear. What the spear does is it gives us a little bit of distance between the human hand and the food, so they, because sharks learn behaviors very quickly, and if we were to hand them right out of our hand, they'd learn that hands are food, and then they'd chase down everybody and try to bite their hands.
Ow.
It was time to chainmail up again. Even if a shark attacked me by mistake, its teeth wouldn't be able to bite through my strong chainmail.
Good luck, Con.
Thanks, sir.
The moment had arrived. It was time to become a shark feeder.
Oh my word, there's so many sharks here. Unbelievable. And they all look hungry. So that's the box with all the fish heads in. They kind of know what's in the box. Food. I'm going to now take the stick and feed the first shark. Oh my gosh, it's taking the meat off the stick. That is so surreal. Wow, everyone, I fed my first bit of meat to the shark. They're absolutely everywhere. They've gone wild. Oh, I just got really bashed by a shark. It's really hard to actually get the meat on the stick. I don't quite know if I can do this. Ah, I keep getting whacked by sharks. There's so many of them. This is absolutely amazing. That is a shark. They have so many rows of teeth, so they just sometimes lose them and throw new ones. Right, we're going for another big chunk of meat then.
Connie looked like she'd been feeding sharks her whole life.
We've got a lot of bumping and bashing, but it was really,
really good. Yeah, bumping and bashing.
And they're beating her up, kicking her in the face. She was fantastic.
Diving and hand-feeding the sharks with Stuart was such an amazing experience. It really made me change my perception of these beautiful creatures.
I don't even know where to start with that.
Scared.
The feet, and then you got headbutted by a shark.
I know, bonk, right there.
Yeah.
It was just, it was amazing.
Hey, Baz, would you like sharks?
Oh, scared of it. I do a shark impression. Watch this.
Go on, Baz.
Go on, Baz.
I'll do the cello. You ready?
Watch the tail.
Oh, you're biting me.
That'll teach you to rip my DVDs.
I'm biting on this show. Like, if you guys would like to send us in any challenges here in the studio, don't hesitate. You can either email us via the website or you can send it to this address. That's Blue Peter, BBC Television Centre, London, W12 7RJ. Now, Basil, what kind of challenge would you like to do?
Well, I'd like to be the first fox in space, tell a few jokes and create some atmosphere. Boom, boom!
Well, you stop
it. Barney, can you tell that?
Do you know what? It's a fairly new one. After watching your bungee jumping video, I'd quite like to give bungee jumping a go. You know?
All right, any particular location?
Victoria Falls apparently is the place to do it.
Oh, so.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's long.
Yeah, I'd give that a go.
Braver man than me. Good. Now, well, if you'd like to see us do some challenges, get in touch and we'll have a crack at them, won't we, guys?
Sure.
Why not? Now, we've been talking about the appeal a lot today. Loads of you have been getting involved already. We've got a bit of a list here. Basil, you go first.
Oh, yes. Antonia, who is 10 years old, has so far collected...